to order. First item is to announce an executive session held July 28th to discuss personnel, and August 4th, 2014, to discuss personnel litigation and real estate. Now's the time when we'll hear a public comment on non-agenda items. Does anybody have any comments? Harry, extend.
I have some PennDOT type questions, so I'm not sure this is the right.
If I can answer, we can answer what we will.
I'm seeing little orange markers, maybe sticking up 4 inches off the road, a foot off the road up in the air.
That's not a PennDOT thing, that's a county thing.
It's a county, what does that mean?
The bridge on Horseshoe Trail between Mill Road and Hollow Road.
Yeah.
Is scheduled to be closed by the county for maintenance on August 18th for 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
And they're where the detour signs go. Those little orange painted stubs or signs go in those.
Okay, and so it's closed, when that's closed, it's closed 24 hours a day?
Yes.
Okay, so.
Yeah, and the county told us 2 weeks.
We've got to figure it out, what's the, okay. So, shops, I thought I had a couple questions. But it turns out the orange markers are showing where to put the detour signs.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome. Brian, Charlie.
I'm gonna follow right on that. What are they doing to the bridge?
The engineer from the county told me they're going to resurface the bridge. I don't know what that means, that's what he said.
So it's just a resurfacing as opposed to big structural repairs or something like that?
He said resurfacing would take 2 weeks.
Okay.
Actually, I think he said maybe up to, maybe, should be done in 2 weeks, so. You know, I would think that they'd be done faster, but they're giving themselves some weather or some breakdown time.
Better to overperform as opposed to we're running late.
Right.
Do we have any group purchase agreements in place for salt and anti-skid for the 2014 and 2015 snow season?
Anti-skid, we do not. Salt, I think we signed up for that, didn't we, Tammy?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay, who do we have it with? Is that the state or other groups?
Tammy, who is it?
CoStars program.
The CoStars.
Okay. Let's see. Who verifies the mileage reimbursements that are appropriate and correct? And the reason I'm asking this is that Resolution 4 of 2014 states that the employees will be reimbursed at 56 cents per mile. And I noticed in the 28th of July 14 bills list, it shows Sandra L. Cantrell Edwards bill, blah, 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 and it says for 411 miles, $393.12. Doing the math, that's 96 cents per mile. Then from this one's bill list, Glenn Derry for animal control mileage, 25.9 miles, and it came to 1674, which comes out to 65 cents a mile, which is a lot closer, but both of them are high.
Okay. John, David?
I don't think I'm gonna be able to answer that without Jim here. As a township manager, those people report to him, but we can certainly. Where is Jim?
Oh, he took down sick. Called him a lot earlier today. Said he wouldn't be able to be here.
Should I go and shoot that to him as an email and get an answer that way?
Yeah, I'll tell you what I know about it. The township treasurer, the one that authorizes payment, she goes over the mileage, and when mileage is submitted, it's submitted by MapQuest Miles, and it's actually a printout.
Okay.
MapQuest printout from the address, you know, origination and destination.
Okay.
So that's how it's done. It's not odometer miles, or it's not, you know, word of mouth. It's actually MapQuest, you know, printed out.
Okay. So. Okay, that still doesn't get us, you know.
Yeah, I don't know about that. That's not right. So.
And I'm going to go with the last one for right now. Who provides permission to drill a series of holes in West Vincent Roads? Or do we have a linear prairie dog count moving in? There's a line of about 3 to 4 inch holes in a road down Eagle Farms Road with the drilling debris still in the road.
I don't know, because I didn't know it was done.
You said, no, I didn't know it was done. We didn't do it.
What's that again? Debris.
The township didn't do it.
Just the debris.
I would assume, though, that the township people should be checking with permission with the township before they drill holes in the road.
Excuse me, that might be core sampling from Ken Yerger on Eagle Farms, Ken.
Could be.
Because they were doing that to verify the subbase on that road at one point.
Okay. Well, then that was authorized by the township. If that's the case, I didn't know about that. But Eagle Farms is getting ready to ask us to take dedication of the paved roads in the portion next to Fellowship Road, you know, that back half of the development that's built now.
Yes.
And one thing we do is we get our engineer to take core samples and make sure that the cross-section of the roads and the base is correct.
Okay, so Ken Yerger asked for it, but nobody in the township knew about it. Is that...
Well, I didn't know about it.
Okay.
I didn't know about it. I don't know about anybody else, so...
Let's see, of the township people that are in the room here, does anyone know about it?
Jim probably does, but he's not here.
Okay. I will go and ask about that question by email also. That's it for me right now. Thank you.
Other comments? Yes, Mrs. Ellis.
The chief is here tonight, but I wanted to thank him. He was very instrumental in clearing the overgrowth at Flowing Springs and St. Matthew's Road. And it was done by Lee PennDOT, had nothing to do with it. So I did write him personally and thank him. But now it's safe to make a left-hand turn on the St. Matthew's Road and neck it run down.
Okay, well, I'll make sure we relay a message to the chief. Thanks.
Okay, I put it in writing to him, too.
Okay, thank you.
Other
comments? I would need to approve the minutes of July 14th and July 28th, 2014 supervisor meeting.
I'll make the motion that we approve those minutes.
Second. The 14th, the second one, not attended.
I'll make a second to the other meeting. Any comment? Yes, Brian.
Are the names of the residents who spoke at those meetings and their concerns noted in the meeting minutes?
No.
You know, if that's the case, why not?
Haven't we had this discussion before? Ad nauseum?
10 times.
But I think it was put on the, it was tabled the last time we talked about it. That was about a month, maybe a month and a half ago. And then both David and I went on vacation. I don't think it was ever resolved.
Well, the reason I'm asking is that the minutes serve as the only formal record of the meeting. And Jim has pointed that out to me in the past. And I believe that a reasonable person would expect to be accurate, similar to, but not exact, or verbatim as court recordings are, so they might be referred to at a later date if any questions or problems arise. And so if they're not complete, you know, we've got a problem, I think, because basically you're saying if you spoke at the meeting, but it's not in the meeting minutes, it didn't happen.
Brian, I agree with you, okay? But other townships do it this way, too. So there's no singular right or wrong reason, to my knowledge. Stephen, am I correct in that assessment?
That's correct, and I think what we said officially was that official business and persons appearing on official business would have to be recorded. And the question was, what is official business? And I think we said public comment was not official business.
Well, the law states that the meetings have to take comment from the residents of the municipality, or they can take it. So that would seem that the law recognizes them as officially, you know, appearing at the meeting.
Not correct. And when you get the JD, you can tell me what the law is, but that's not what the law says is, as it pertains to minutes, is what I just told you. Those persons appearing before the township on official business.
Can you tell me, you know, where that definition of official business is?
I can.
Could you tell me it, please?
Not at this juncture.
Okay, what is it going to take to get it?
I think they'll have to authorize me to do that because I give legal advice to the board and the township and not to members of the public.
Okay.
Can I interject?
Yeah.
I thought we were going to bring this up and put it on as an agenda item going back maybe a month and a half, and never did, but like I said, I was on vacation. I know David was on vacation. Does it make sense at this juncture to put it on for next, and decide the issue once and for all, just get done with it?
Yeah, that'd be good. That'd be okay with me. Okay. Other comments, Brian?
That's it, thank you.
Maria, comment?
Just on that same topic, if you don't mind, and I appreciate that you're going to put it back on the agenda, seems to me that it kind of went back into a black hole, and this happens frequently, which is all the more reason why they have to get on the minutes. This was talked about at a prior meeting, it was decided that it would be put up for the supervisors. What is even a little more upsetting is the fact that the supervisors didn't ask for it to stop being recorded. It just stopped being recorded, it certainly wasn't done in the public if you decided it someplace else. It didn't happen here. And I don't quite understand how that occurred, that all of a sudden, minutes were being kept correctly with, and you know, I understand not putting every word in, but a person's name and the topic is relevant. And how did that stop happening? And then why wouldn't the, when it was brought to the supervisor's attention that, hey, this stopped happening, and we said that it was going to be put on an agenda, why doesn't it end up back on an agenda?
I guess we're not perfect.
Well, I appreciate that, but nonetheless, it's really not a good enough answer.
I don't know how it got changed or whatever, it just did. And that's when it brought up, we discussed it, and we noted that at that time, and we just got to correct it, and we haven't done it, but it'll be corrected within 2 weeks.
Okay, Maria?
Sure.
Other comments?
Maybe we can just leave them off.
What's that?
Unless someone has an official comment, we can just leave it off, because then everything becomes searchable on the internet. There's no context or relevance. So maybe if you want to know, come to a meeting. Otherwise, official business is official business. People making comments offhand about something or just bringing it to the board's attention doesn't need to be verbatim or even recognized in the minutes. It takes a lot of time, and then it brings up opportunities for those with nefarious interests to just start trashing people. So why don't we just make it, if you have a comment, come to the meeting, the board's aware of it, we're good. That's all.
Thank you. Another opinion? Any other comments? Reports are next. There is no township manager.
Wait a minute, you never voted on the minutes.
Right. Oh, no. Sorry. Motion to make and seconded. If there's no comment, all in favor?
Aye.
No report from the manager today, tonight. Road manager's report. For August 2014, we conducted ongoing maintenance and repair on township equipment, filling potholes in various roads in the township, mowed several roads in the township, removed tree limbs from various roads in the township, opened pipes and inlets on various roads in the township, patched several roads in the township, worked with contractor on repairs to Flowing Springs Road and St. Matthews Road, and also Adelphi Lane, and sprayed weeds at the sewer plants around the fences and the dunes. Active subdivision report is next. We have nothing that requires action this evening. Bill's list is next. There's a bill payable to me on the bill's list, so I can't vote on it. The bill's list, so John and David, if you want to go ahead and make a motion, consider approving it.
Move the approval of the bill's list. August 11th, 2014, the township bills list being $112,027.62. Reimbursable bills list $14,189.88. Subdivision utility plant bills list $19,093.98.
I'll second the motion.
Is there any comment? Brian, I think you're first. It was close, but he wasn't.
I'll defer to somebody else first. But if you want me, okay. Under card member services, there's a thing for seeding the Birch Run off space. What is the Birch Run? I believe it's probably open space.
It's the old township building site that we purchased.
Okay, so that's what that's being at least temporarily named or used as a name for them?
Yeah.
Okay. Under Cedar Hollow Land Development, there's, let's see, 2A material, 366 tons to St. Matthews Road and Bertolet Road. What are we doing Bertolet Road recently?
It's Bertolet Road.
Okay.
And we graded it, filled potholes.
Okay. There's a bill for, again, Cedar Hollow for 207 tons of dirt. What road was that one associated with?
I don't know, it all goes into the same pile.
Okay. Okay, on D&L Construction, there's work being done on Sawmill Road. What's its stuff being done on it now?
Inlets and pipes for stormwater drainage.
Okay. Probably going to go and give you this one too. For Douglasville Quarry, you got 45 tons of stone. Is that various roads or some specific road?
I have to check the dates on the receipts for the dumping permit, you know, when they were dumped here.
Okay.
I can tell you then.
I'll drop you an email. Drive Corp, there says diamond blades. Where were the diamond blade tools used? What were they used for?
I can't give you where they were used. They've been, that's the first blades we put on in 2 years.
Okay.
Used for cutting concrete and blacktop.
Okay. So we've been cutting concrete and blacktop somewhere?
Yeah.
Okay. George Wallach for the Griffith Elson barn, it says, repairs the barn. I thought we made the final payment on that a couple months ago.
We did on that, but there was an emergency repair. One of the window frames had cracked and the stone on top of it was starting to fall down.
Okay.
So it got to be a more complicated thing than what we first thought, but it's repaired now.
Okay, and we, in other words, we just stuck with the guy that was working on it before.
Yes.
Okay. Martin Stone Quarries. We got 70 tons and 165 tons. It says 1 to 4 inches stones. What roads were they on?
That one on the, in the ditches on St. Matthews, or St. Matthews River that we paved.
Okay. Well, we put that down before we put the finer stuff down?
Yes.
Okay. Total rental. We have a, a roller rental. We've got it, that in a roller rental for rollers listed in the labor and equipment listing. Is there some reason why we had to buy yet another roller?
Or we didn't buy a roller, we rented a roller.
Okay.
The Township Road Crew was patching roads with hot asphalt, and you have to roll it in. So we rented a roller.
Was that cheaper than using the equipment labor bid roller?
Well, we didn't have the patches that we did. We didn't have Fleck hired to do that.
Okay.
Just in-house.
Okay, that's it for right now. Thank you.
Okay, Ms. Sells.
District County SPCA. Animal boarding for the second quarter is $1,000. I thought we had our own kennel here.
I don't know the terms of our contract with Chester County SPCA, so John or David.
I thought that we paid them a yearly fee so that if there was a stray dog that they could come and collect it, or we could actually take it there. So I was just wondering what, you know, what this boarding was for.
No, I think
the answer.
Yeah, I have no idea, but I think what you're talking about. Wasn't there a 500
annual contract? Annual contract, yeah.
But this is something different. This is the Chester County SPCA, not animal control. We're going to have to get back to that.
Okay. One other thing that Brian brought up about putting the roof on that old building, what are we going to do with that building? We actually, it's in such bad shape, it seems like it would take a fortune to fix it up. I can see where you'd have to maintain the roof, but I can see saving the barn, but that structure really looks like it's like falling apart.
What building are you talking about?
The house.
Griffith Farm.
Yeah, the repair was done to the barn.
Pardon me?
The repair was done to the barn.
I also thought that repairs were done to the roof of the house.
No.
No. But do we have plans for the house?
Yeah, we do. And actually, Jim's soliciting phone bids now for repairs of the house.
Okay, that's a pretty hefty sum. Looks like it's in really bad shape. Okay, thank you. That's it.
Okay. Brian, anything else? Any other comments? Debbie, what's...
I just have to say, Ken, you know, Brian asks these questions every meeting, lots of questions, and you always have, almost always have the answers for them. You have them right at the top of your head, and I just want to applaud you, because I think that's great that you can just give him most of the answers he needs. Nobody else has questions like that. I think he just goes through stuff, well, every 2 weeks, just to bring up all these questions, but you do have the answers.
I think Brian makes believe he has a leash around my neck, and every time he asks a question, he's yanking on it. That's my personal opinion.
You do have the answers, and I just think that's great that we have a supervisor that can answer those questions, boom, 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 so...
Everybody up here knows a lot of stuff. It's just that most of the questions are about road stuff, since I'm the road master, that's my area. Where? Oh, Maria, sorry.
Okay, only a question that you have with the SPCA, if you don't know what the $1,000 is, can we exclude that from the approval of the bills? Because you're gonna write a check for $1,000 if you don't know what you're approving.
The whole idea of the supervisors approving the bills list that the treasurer is already approved and the township managers will already approve. We'll get back into that $1,000 and have an answer for it. But there's no reason to not pay that invoice. Did I say that right?
Yeah. Other comments?
All in favor of the motion to approve the bill list, please say aye.
Aye.
Okay, under correspondence, we have a quote on painting lines at the intersection of Route 100 and 401. We have one from Guidemark, pavement marking contractor for $4,960. And they're not painted on, it's hot thermoplastic product. Right.
The only company in the area that uses that power.
Okay. Do you hear a motion to approve this quote?
It was the only bid we got?
Yeah. I called other people and nobody does it.
Call on Francis.
I called three other companies and nobody else could do it.
Is it, before we, is it sound close to what we paid in the past?
I think it is. It's a little higher, but if I remember.
It's higher because there's additional striking that needs to get done.
Yeah. I don't know, less than 4,000, but not a lot less the last time.
And when was it done last?
2 years ago.
But did we approve it?
Second.
Any comment, Francis?
Actually, so this is a question. Is it, I noticed on Route 100 that where the markings are, that the roadbed is actually coming up. See, when you ride over, like turn ahead, or that you could actually feel that the road is there. Is this the same type of markings that we're going to put at that intersection?
I don't know. It's a PennDOT approved product. PennDOT has requirements for road markings for stop signs and crosswalks at intersections.
What good are markings on Route 100 if they make holes in the road?
I don't know if this product will do that or not.
Okay.
It's a PennDOT spec that...
I was just asking if it was the same
thing. Yeah. I've asked several people about that, and nobody can tell me why that happened either. On Route 100.
But it looks like actually maybe part of it was at one point chiseled out, probably something was poured into it to make the sign.
I don't know. Richard, no.
I think what she's speaking of was they actually machined some of the roadway away and, you know, set the wording down into the road. And then with the severe winter that we had, with the opening into the substructure of the blacktop, it allowed freeze and thaw and then push the road apart. And what they want to do out here at the intersection will not have that.
Okay. Okay. I didn't know that. I didn't know that they built the road out to put those.
I know where they have turn ahead and they had to slow down bars and all that the people complained about, and they actually came back and filled some weight material into them. But they opened up the roadway, and then with the freeze and thaw and the water getting into it, it pushed the road surface apart.
Okay. Okay. Thanks, Richard. Is that that help?
Oh, yes, it does. It was, you know what, every time I write over that, I ask the same question to myself.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any other comments? Motion's made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
We have a request to use the parking gazebo on September 6th from Rachel Buck of 2568 Horseshoe Trail for a children's birthday party. Vince, have your motion?
Make your motion that we approve this request.
Second.
Any comment? All those in favor?
We have no conflict.
No conflict.
All those in favor?
Aye.
We have a request from East Nantville Township for the Lowest Corner Fire Police to assist with the Green Valley Association 5K run on September 6th. Signed by Jim Jenkins, Supervisor, so that meets the workers' comp requirements. Do I hear a motion to approve this request?
So moved.
Second.
Any comment?
Yeah, I'm just curious. This is for their... This is for whom?
East Nantville Township has to ask, has to request that our fire police are allowed to go into their townships to make sure that those fire police...
I'm sorry, I misunderstood. That's...
And Green Valley's, the event's going to, I guess, going to be in East Nantville.
Yeah, I thought it was the other way around, asking for permission to come into our township rather than...
Okay, motion made and seconded. Any comments? All those in favor?
Aye.
Writings at West Vincent, Mr. McBride.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just comparable, this would be out of use of this plan.
Yeah, if you remember, the pegs fall out.
No, I think they actually got some under it.
Good evening. My name's Richard McBride. For the members that weren't on the board for the 10 years or so that this went through the process. This is the actual approved final plan for the Writings at West Vincent. It sits at the corner of Beaver Hill and St. Matthews Road. Consists of about 150 acres. What you're seeing here is the actual approved subdivision. It started in 2003. I think the plan was finally approved with the usual complete details, the formal final plan resolution. It was originally a text amendment to the ordinance. 50 of the acres are on the, we'll call it the south side of St. Matthews Road. That will be one conservation lot with the existing farmhouse. About 30 some acres is proposed to be given over to the township as open space, and also this treatment facility and the water facilities for the site, which are community systems, would be on the south side of the road. On the opposite side of the road, the plan changed some in the conditional use process. First, the township amended the ordinance, and the only thing that the ordinance did was to allow for a property split by a road to have all the units on one side, because in your township you have clustering, for want of a better word, which this is, it does. Your ordinance allows so many units per acre after you subtract out environmentally sensitive and you provide open space. So, long story short, the text amendment was adopted after a year or so, and then there was a conditional use hearing, and when the conditional use was approved, the neighbor appealed it to the court, and it went around in circles in the court for a little bit and came back to the township. The neighbor, Bob Cassiato, with whom we're very friendly now, at the time we didn't know one another, and he had an attorney, and I think the chairman remembers all those hearings. The ultimate plan actually removed all the lots next to Bob's property. And in lieu of those, there's two more conservation or conservancy lots, which takes up that entire meadow. And I think anybody that's familiar with the area, you go past their horse stables, et cetera, they would be in this vicinity as depicted on here. And therefore, the view sheds in this area are beautiful, and all that would be retained. When the plan was ultimately approved, there was a lot of input both from the neighbors and from township staff, resulting in exactly where the road connections would be made to Beaver Hill and out to St. Matthews. And after a number of years, 5 or 6 years, it was finally approved. And with that, the economy cratered, and nobody was building houses anywhere. We're somewhat coming out of that. And what we had to discuss this evening was an alternative to the particular plan that you see. What you have are The 74 lots, in addition to the conservancy lots and some TDRs to go with the Cassiato property. The property is actually, as it shows in the plan, approved for or entitled to 89 units. In order to build the first house, however, you have to build the sewer treatment plant, you have to build a water facility. So the front-end cost is different than in many municipalities or areas where those facilities are there. You go in for a building permit, you pay your tapping fee. Here you're looking at about $4 million in addition to several million for the infrastructure. Banks are not about to finance something like that because the cost spread over the lots are so large for the 74 lot. So I'm looking for a way to make it sense in a manner that does actually decreases the impact of the community and provides benefits to the community. You know, you have a lot of people stand up and give you glowing talks about it's a win-win situation. I'm not going to go that far. It's an approach to shift it from standard five-bedroom single-family homes to just age-restricted homes. And that's by law, as council could advise you, something that is fully enforceable. Residents have to be a minimum of 55 years of age. You can have no school-age children. You're not entitled to have children as a permanent resident. They're less than 19 years of age. So for the school district, all the revenues are gained. There's no cost. For the township, all the infrastructure, other than what the township wants to take. The township wants the only the open space, I assume that's still the case, as well as the water and sewer facilities. But the road maintenance would all be part of a homeowners association. I bought some, just for way of a real quick comparison, what the plan looks like. The plan will look the same because the roads, the road location, were things that were very important to township, the open space and things of that nature. The drip fuels for the sprayer for the drip irrigation would remain the same. If you look at the plan that's there and compare it with just a rough sketch of what the housing would look like, this is single family detached housing. But you're talking about a two bedroom unit rather than a five bedroom unit, talking about no school age children. Toll Brothers has a very similar project over in Upper Providence, Regency. What some of the glossy photos that they have of the product over there, just for example, you can see we are talking about single family detached. So what's in there? That's the same. There's two different models here, the Insider, and then I've got other brochures that are readily available. Very popular product, and I think would serve the existing township in terms of your housing mix well. At the end of the day, it would require a text amendment. If the board had interest in going further, and it's the whole purpose of coming here this evening, if there's interest in looking into it, I work with the township solicitor and staff in terms of what the amendment would look like. You do a text amendment, and the term that I've often heard in other communities, that's a great idea on that property, but we don't want unforeseen consequences elsewhere. You don't want to necessarily see it, so you might consider some map change. You'll want to be convinced at the time of any hearing that, in fact, your impacts aren't going to be greater, they're actually lesser. You have, you would have more units per se, but you're going to have fewer bedrooms, fewer people, fewer car trips, and a total revenue plus, and the same effective layout as you see on the plane in front of you. I think to go much further than that would almost be getting into the sort of presentation you would make at a hearing. Be happy to answer any questions in terms of other projects where this type of product is, it's everywhere anymore. Most communities do provide for it. Most communities have come to realize that a lot of us are at the age where we would qualify for this sort of thing. People would like to have the option of staying in the community or where they are when they reach the point where they're not interested in the property maintenance and the house where they raised the family. So this services that need. I'd be happy to answer any questions. The approach, end of story, would be develop the property essentially as you've already approved it. Everything that was proposed to the township would be provided to the township in terms of the park contributions, the park land, the water and sewer facilities. You're going to have fewer bedrooms, fewer people, but they'd be in a larger number of boxes, which would be part of the zoning process.
So how many units addition?
Ultimately, most ordinances are between 2.5 and 3 times the number of single-family homes, which equates to the number of bedrooms. It wouldn't be approached that, perhaps 2. Matter of having something that can actually fund the improvements and without exceeding and actually even reaching what your current yield would be in terms of people, car trips. Not only fewer people, but the actual car trips, it's really the peak out. You're not dealing with soccer moms, you're not dealing with school children. The trip patterns are just totally different.
I get that. And that you said you're going to provide later, but you're talking about approximately 148, 150 units versus
that. Yeah, that would be approximately it, yes, sir. And Mr. Cassiato still gets his lots. And I've spoken to Bob, he's aware of it. I've spoken to most people that would have immediate interest in it, and they're aware of the fact that I would be here this evening.
The DEP sewage flow would be the same?
Pardon me?
The DEP approved sewage flow per unit?
Yes.
Yes. Or whatever.
Yes.
So.
The DEP, we have an approved 537 plan. Drip fields were sized out and tested for their permeability. And it's another one. Your gallons per day for a house of this size versus the other is approximately, not even half. And the flows, the total amount of flows was way above. If you recall, it allowed for the number of houses plus 30 more. It's about 29,000 something other per day it's approved for in the drip fields.
What do you guys think? Take it under advisement? Get back to him? Mm-hmm.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. I think
that would be excited.
I appreciate it. I was looking for an answer per se. I'll follow up with either Jim when he's back or the solicitor if you want to hear further or give you more glossy prints and a more formal presentation. If it's worthy of that, you can back to us and we'll be back in front of you.
Okay.
Thank you, folks.
Okay, thank you.
I'm going to put the diesel back.
I do not need the
diesel. Okay.
I'm here tonight for the public hall agreement.
For courtyards at Webbistown?
Yes.
Yep. That's on Bertrand Road between West Overland and Webbistown.
Okay. Yes, Bertrand Road, actually as close to West Overland as we could possibly get. That's where the sewage treatment facility is going to go. There's a terminal manhole. We'll pump out of the terminal manhole into a frac tank. Take it from the frac tank to an approved sewage disposal site. Would be treated and disposed of. Part of the permit process, we have to go to DEP in order to go to DEP. I'm looking for the way to approve the agreement so I can continue the permit process.
Okay, John, David, you reviewed the correspondence between the tank and representatives and our solicitor and board?
Yes.
I have not.
Would you like to
just give me 1 minute?
Oh, okay. If I'm wrong with any of these things, correct me.
Okay.
But the sewage will be called the Pottstown Sewage Disposal Plant or one of 2 other
correct
default options.
Correct.
$65,000 to replace in an escrow account for the township in case Hankin runs into some difficulties.
Correct.
Aqua America will be the operator of the system and responsible for the pump and all.
Correct. And there's an agreement with Aqua as part of the.
Yeah. And I saw that too. And that, they're the ones that monitor it on a daily basis and they're responsible for notifying DEP and the township.
Correct.
But then I think it's a few hours.
Yeah, they have to come out and do maintenance minimum of every 3 days. And there's an alarm system with an auto dialer within the frac tank should a problem arise. It gives both them and us and the municipality notification that there's a problem.
What's the number of units?
60.
Okay, yeah, I knew that was here, I see. Any other questions, you guys?
The only thing, when I read the agreement, it starts, its effective date is January 1st, 15?
Effective date is January 1st.
Of 2015.
Okay.
Not used before then?
Well, it takes that long to get the first house up and occupied.
And the only other, one thing that I really didn't understand is why we have to be part of this agreement?
DEP requirement.
DEP wanted to pump a hole out of the municipality. Hank and Mike over tomorrow, they want to, but they might have the township never was away.
Okay, then would it matter to us to know what this agreement, what the monthly cost is, because there's nothing in here about that?
And there was a schedule with the monthly cost in it.
Well, that's a complete...
But it's not in here, though, in their eyes. So, do you do that? Neil, I don't know the numbers off.
That's what the escrow was based off. And the escrow was reviewed and approved by the township engineer.
Say that again, please?
The escrow was based off of that. So the escrow was set up to make sure that there were funds available for pumping and hauling. And that was reviewed and approved by your township engineer.
I just wish I knew the number. If we're going to obligate the township, I'd like to know the number we're obligating the township for. I mean, the fee schedule that I saw on the original copy that I got had some hourly quotes on stuff, but it didn't have the base number, and nowhere did it get to be a total. I mean, if I'm overreaching.
No, I don't think so.
I need to hold up this agreement for that, you know. David?
Can you maybe give us a summary of how this $65,000 was reached?
You know, you have to make an assumption as far as the number of units that will come online. For instance, and we already have a time clock that is established between, with the sewer agreement that says within a year, basically we have 1 year from occupying our first house, we have to start building the sewer treatment plant. From that point, we get 1 year to basically complete the sewer treatment plant and turn it over, make it operational, turn it over to the municipality. So we're talking about a 2 year time frame. Within that first year, your sewer flows are going to be almost non-existent. And then, we have a good year, we sell, what did we sell this year at Weatherstone? 12 houses. We're not going to come anywhere close to $65,000 a year in pumping and hauling fees over really, well, say, an 18-month to 2-year period.
Okay, that what you're saying is that there's plenty of safety margin there, but you haven't explained how the $65,000 figure.
It's based on, so you make an assumption on your absorption. Your absorption, then you calculate, all right, I've got a house that's online, it's pumping out at our sewage flow for Weatherstone is actually less than 100 gallons a day. We're running high 90s. You know, if you get an active day, maybe you're at 105 gallons a day. Multiply that flow rate by the number of days you got to pump it out. And there's a service charge, Aqua. We have an agreement with Aqua. They charge typically 3 cents a gallon.
So the $65,000 represents the estimate of how long? How long is it pump and haul?
Say
full 2 years?
No. If I had to guess, I'm going to say it's probably an 8 month to a year period.
And the township engineer has approved it?
Township engineer reviewed it and approved it.
Any other questions, John?
No, I'm satisfied.
I'm ready to go forward. Okay. Do I hear then a motion to approve pump of all plan agreement as presented to us tonight?
So moved. Second.
Any comments? Those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Sidewalk ordinance is next. Steve, do you want to handle this one?
Yes. This ordinance was advertised on July 22nd and July 29th in the Mercury. And I have here a copy of the proof of publication that will mark as Township Exhibit 1, as well as the actual text of the advertisement that will mark as Township Exhibit 2. The Township Exhibit 2 provides a summary description of the ordinance, which I think I'll just go through for the benefit of everyone here. Section 1 authorizes the Township to undertake the planning and construction of a sidewalk installation on all properties within the LVCC zoning district and uniform taxpayer tax parcel identifier number 25-7-8.1, fronting on Route 100 and on Route 401, for which the owners thereof shall be required to reimburse the Township pursuant to the second class Township code. Section 2 provides that the sidewalk and any grading or other structures necessary to construct the same shall be constructed in accordance with the applicable regulation in the Township Subdivision Ordinance, Subdivision Land Development Ordinance. Section 3 provides that the landowners of the affected property shall be required to reimburse the Township for the costs associated with the same, limited to 15% of the assessed values of such properties. Section 4 authorizes the Township Manager, Engineer, Solicitor, Secretary, and Staff to secure and undertake all necessary approvals. Section 5 provides for repeal of conflicting ordinances or parts of ordinances to the extent of such conflict. Section 6 provides that if any part of the ordinance is found to be invalid, such shall not affect the remaining provisions. And Section 7 establishes an effective date of 5 days after adoption. I also have in front of me a full copy of the ordinance, which we'll label as Township Exhibit 3. Actual copy of the ordinance.
Before we have the motion, is it okay if I ask some questions on this?
Yes.
This ordinance references 13 properties. Not just the McKay property, but 13 in properties. I had an opportunity to look most of them up. I'm not sure I got them all, though. I ran out of time. So that's my first concern, because there's no other action after we pass this that needs to be taken, that these sidewalks, according to this terminology, it says, let me get this right. This hereby authorizes and requires that sidewalks be constructed on these 13 properties. So going to have to go forward on them unless we insert language that, you know, to some other extent. And I believe it goes up, some of these properties go up to where Sweetwater, not construction, whatever they're calling it, used to be Mulch Man, down all the way down to Route 100. So if this is correct, and I'm reading this correct, and it requires it, then we're going to place sidewalks right up Route 100. And that may not be needed for 15 years or 10 years or whatever. So that's something that concerns me, that no further action is going to be needed to start construction on all those sidewalks. I mean, I'm in favor of the McCabe, you know, sidewalk, make no mistake about that. But this goes a little bit further than that.
I think as I read this, and I'm going to ask Steve to comment on this, it authorizes and requires, but it doesn't specify that it has to happen right now. Correct?
Right. There's no timing on it.
Right. But so it's a long-term authorization.
But it doesn't say that. It says it's required. And then down in Section 4, it says, the Township Manager, Solicitor, Engineer, Secretary, and Staff shall be authorized to secure any and all necessary approvals. So without any more Board of Supervisors action, Tammy could call up and get a contractor to put in sidewalks without ever coming back to us for approval. That's why I think there needs to be some language about that, because Tammy wants those sidewalks in.
No, this isn't worded the way that I thought it would be. The intent is there, but the,
yes.
I guess the mode of execution is not what I thought it would be. And David, if you see it that way or a different way.
Well, I think that the it's a long-range document, and I don't think it has a timetable. And in generally, my understanding, subject to Steve's correction, is that if a term is not specified, what is read into the ordinance is a reasonable period. And reasonable, to me, would say when the need arises. Your point is interesting, John, about the no further action being taken necessarily by the supervisor. On the other hand, the supervisor certainly, if the staff proposed to do something that we didn't approve of, we could stop it. So, but your point's valid about that.
But it also requires, and I think, if I'm not mistaken, these 13 properties were probably picked out part of the Ludwig's Corner Strategic Vision Plan. And I mean, that's where I assume it came from, but it probably makes sense. And it probably is a good idea, but in what order? I mean, if those properties aren't, you know, developed, this, I don't know, it just concerns me that those words, authorize and requires.
I could probably go along with this as it is, but I'd like to hear from Ken.
I share some of John's concerns. It does look like pretty arbitrary and subtle. And I don't know if there's something that I'm not reading here, Steve, or something.
Well, the and requires language was so that all the parcels are treated the same. We can strike the and requires language and authorize that sidewalks be constructed by the township at the expense of the owners. And we could say at such time, you know, as may be elected by the township, so you can put a time frame, a flexible time frame into it. There are other options within our land development ordinances now and zoning ordinances now for the treatment of the installation of sidewalks, and those remain. So I think if you struck, listening to John's comments, and requires, and then added at the conclusion of following the description of the rights of way, Conestoga Road and Pottstown Pike, a phrase that said, at such time frames as may be determined by the township, would that give you the flexibility that you're looking for the out?
Yes, I think it goes a long way to that regard.
And my concern about that is this, Stephen, and maybe you can explain this, or make us feel better about it. Would we have to re-advertise this whole thing if we're going to make that kind of change?
You know, the safest answer I can give you is yes.
Okay.
The question is this a material amendment to the ordinance? You are providing for flexibility, and you are reducing the requirement that was in there. So I don't necessarily view it as material, but I'd like rather reserve on that.
Okay. Well, then
the net effect of that, though, David, would be advertising it and waiting 2 weeks.
Yeah.
The cost of advertising it is how much?
$300 some.
I'm not worried about that so much as I am. This sidewalk is really a necessity. I think it's something that we really want to get done. I mean, what about this? What about the possibility of approving this ordinance with the understanding that we're going to amend it and delete that word, or those words?
Well, if we're talking about amending and deleting the word, Section 3 has a word in there I'd like to change. We talked about this at the last meeting. I think we discussed this. Where it says above reference property shall be obligated to reimburse the township for all costs up to 15%. I thought that we had discussed, I don't know if we agreed to it or not, changing shall to may.
I think what we talked about was that the township doesn't have to necessarily enforce the ordinance, but I don't know that we talked about writing the ordinance in such a manner that it was discretionary. Because then you have built into the ordinance the challenge as to whether you actually have the right. So I think we talked that the township always has the option of backing off of some of that, but I don't think we talked about changing the text.
Steve, what do you think is a matter of procedure of our approving this ordinance with the understanding that we're going to strike a couple words from it? Is that...
I'd wait the 2 weeks and re-advertise it. Okay. Because I don't think it's that long a period of time. I know that this has been on for a while. We want to get moving on it. Mm-hmm. But I would wait the 2 weeks and re-advertise it, and that way you're safe.
I'll yield to council's advice.
Is that suit, John?
Yeah, I feel bad. I mean, I'd like to get that going too. And I have no objection to it. It just concerned me that it's out of our hands if we sign this document. So.
Yes. The changes that we discussed?
Yes, that's fine.
Okay, so then you want to redo it, re-advertise it, consider it 2 weeks from now? Okay, does everybody understand what's going to happen here? This is us.
There's a sidewalk on Kimberton Road, and it's past the school, and I never see a living soul on that sidewalk. Now, why is it a necessity to have a sidewalk on Route 100? Who's going to stroll up and down Route 100?
Where's the sidewalk on Kimberton Road?
Do you know where the school is, the Catholic school is? There's a sidewalk.
Right.
That actually it stops in the middle of nowhere. But there's no one ever on that sidewalk. There's not kids on the sidewalk. There's no one on that sidewalk.
That's East by the township, is it not?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There's other issues in playing here. There's a school across the street from the library. There apparently is some interaction between both, and giving the children a place to walk safely across the road at a traffic light is very important. And there's other reasons too. I'm making this simple. Also, walking to school gives them the opportunity. It gives them a place to start and do it properly rather than going through somebody's backyard or someone's house. It may be a low volume road, but it's also part of what townships do.
But I never see children even walking to the school bus, much less walking to school.
Well, the guy behind you used to walk from his kids all the way over by the horse show grounds to...
We sure didn't need a sidewalk.
I think enough people have already weighed in that they think the sidewalk's a good idea. I think we're beyond that.
Okay.
Other comments? Well, I mean, does everybody understand what we're doing here? We're postponing this for a minor rewrite with major implications. We're going to consider it 2 weeks from tonight.
One of those implications would be that the other landowners would then be given a tool to force everyone else in that area to do the sidewalks at the same time. If you didn't make that revision. If one was upset that the sidewalk was being foisted upon them, it would then give them just one more opportunity to make that argument. So your clarification and rectification there, I think, is a good idea. And re-advertising is required.
Okay. Anybody else? Francis?
You put a sidewalk on someone's property. Are they responsible if their dog or bites a person on the sidewalk, or kids with their bicycle on their own property run over someone on the sidewalk? Is the complete liability of anyone who uses that sidewalk responsibility of the owner of that property?
Same liability occurs whether there's a sidewalk there or not. If your dog bites somebody walking on your side of Long Springs Road, you have liability.
Yeah, except for your inviting liability when you put the sidewalk in.
How do you figure that?
Well, when you put the sidewalk on, do people use it? How many people are walking on that property right now?
Well, actually, just the other day, I saw three people walking on the driveway, which is three more than walk on the sidewalk at the church in East Michael Township. So. Mrs. Westfall, Debbie Westfall.
I think John had a valid point with what he's saying, that it's definitely needed for the school. Whether those sidewalks move up 100, who knows? And it can happen as more happens on 100, but I think it's a, as we've said before, it's definite at the school.
Okay, so that's what we're going to do. 2 weeks. Oh, George.
Can you just review what you said, you suggested that the township may waive the reimbursement fee?
Yes.
But then you decided not to do that? Is that, what was the?
I suggested we change the shall require to may require. Steve says we can't do that without gutting the enforcement provision of that. Is that right?
You're writing discretion into the ordinance, and somebody will turn around and say, well, it says may, and you don't have to, and I think that puts the township in a weakened posture. Better to have an ordinance that's...
So in other words, you will force them to reimburse. Right? I guess my only concern is that these are undeveloped properties now that may be developed in the future, but if you burden the landowner with costs now, you're encouraging them to develop it, and we know eventually these will be commercial properties, but why rush into it?
Well, I think we're in agreement. We're only going to require one property owner to put in a sidewalk at this time. Well, we're going to put in a sidewalk on one property at this point. It'll take further Board of Supervisors action if this passes the way we structured the change. Then we'll take another action to get another property and so on. As development proceeds or some makes more sense. It's just not going to happen overnight, and that was what I was worried about.
I'll clarify section 4 to make sure that it's clear that Tammy can't go asking for sidewalks until there's board action authorizing. Yeah. Well, neither can I or Ken or Jim. So I'll clarify that as well.
Okay. Anything else? Okay, next item on the agenda is the minor zoning issue. And Steve, you have something you want to say about that?
I received a telephone call from Kristen Camp. It was after the close of township business hours, and she actually did follow up.
Kristen Camp is?
Counsel for the Grimers and Kit Troller. And she sent me also a confirming email that they wanted to be pulled off tonight's agenda because of a conflict. And I'll forward that to you. Tammy.
Under new business, we have the fall field use schedule. Fall schedule is from when to when?
August 25th, I don't know exactly.
Okay, August 25th and November 9th, that's what I read. Okay, what we have is Wednesday for the rectangular field, Wednesday evenings GEYA, Tuesday and Thursday evenings Coventry soccer, both on Fridays, Saturday mornings GEYA, and the Saturday afternoons Coventry soccer. The rectangular field is a soccer field along the 401. Any motion to approve the schedule?
So moved.
Second. Comment? All in favor?
Aye.
Item number 13 is the Massaro litigation settlement. Steve, solicitor.
Yes, this settlement involved cause of action that was filed by Carl Massaro and the Massaro family on Hollow Road, alleging violations of the Stormwater Management Act that caused harm to his property or their property. After 3 or 4 years of going back and forth and with an upcoming trial, the matter has been resolved primarily by the insurance carrier, Township's prior carrier Selective, agreeing to pay to the Massaros $165,000. The Township's proposed contribution to avoid further litigation and costs associated with this matter without admitting to any liability was to pay $35,000. Without any the imposition of any other restrictions, the waiver of any rights by the township. So this matter has been resolved, and a settlement agreement and release are being circulated for execution, and we thought we would have it this evening, but they're still fine-tuning it, and my recommendation would be to authorize and approve the settlement subject to the receipt of a satisfactory settlement agreement and release, both satisfactory to the Board of Supervisors and Solicitor.
I hear a motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
Comments?
So this is a resident hijacking the township to get a pond pipe pumped out?
That's your words, not township's words.
This is all based on silt that they are alleging came down off the hill naturally across ground and into a pond?
Steve, you have to address that.
Is that what this is about?
It is based on those allegations that modification of the stormwater drainage system across Hollow Road adversely impacted the pond and the property.
So existing pipes and natural gravity is now the township's fault. I didn't know God was embodied in this room, but it's interesting. Thank you.
We defended the case. We were prepared to defend the case. The board has opted to consider paying a nominal sum to avoid exposure, time, expense, etc.
I understand that. I don't think the board's wrong. I'm annoyed at one of my neighbors doing something I think is reprehensible. Holding trusted residents hijacked for something they think is an easy way to get something paid for. That's my personal opinion.
Motion been made and seconded. If there are no more comments, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. I hear a motion to adjourn.
You do.
Second.
Comment, all in favor?
Aye.